Hello and welcome to what is our third lesson from our free trading sessions for beginners. If you followed our previous two videos, now you should have the basics to understand the markets. Of course, if you have any questions from the previous two topics, you can leave your questions into the comments below this video and the videos before and we'll answer. And of course, do not hesitate to contact with any of us directly. You can find our contacts into the contact form of our website and we will answer as soon as possible. As I told you the previous time, this is our team, this is me, Valentin, this is our coach and trader into the forex sector, Ilian, and this is our social and community manager, Seva, and we are the team of DM Trading Bulgaria. Here you can find our website and also, of course, it is on the left side, on every slide you can find it here. Today we are at the last lesson from section 1, terminology and basics, and the lesson in question is opening your first trade. So, what you should know before you open your first trade? Here, first, what is margin? Margin is the difference between the total value of securities held in an investor account and the loan amount from the broker. Buying on margin is the act of borrowing money to buy securities. The definition to what is leverage is pretty much close, but they are not the same. The main difference is that leverage is taken on a debt and the margin are just borrowed money for certain investment operations, but in the most brokers they are dependable from each other. So in other words, these two instruments are giving you the opportunity to trade products and securities which you cannot actually afford. Of course, when you start opening your account, there are a variety of settings and options from which you can choose the leverage and margin which is going to fit perfectly for your needs. The spread, however, is something very different, and here it's very important for you to understand it. The most simple definition is that it is the difference between the price of the buyers and the price of the sellers. Here I'm going to show you a real market book from a professional platform. The security in question, as you can see, is SPY. It is representing the US index S&P 500. And as you can see, this is the price of the buyers and this is the price of the sellers. If you want to buy aggressively, you have to hit from the price of the sellers. Sometimes the spread between these two prices can get very big and this could affect your trade management in a bad way, so you have to be very careful with it. So, just to summarize here, in the most cases the spread is very small, especially into the forex market, and it doesn't really matter too much, but sometimes into the less liquid product it might get quite big, which can change your whole plan, so you have to pay attention to it. Now we will continue with something else very important, and it is the overnight swaps. First, let's see what it is. Well, if you have a position open and you leave it overnight, you have to pay a fee which is calculated depending from your position size. This is due to the fact that nowadays almost no one uses cash accounts, and due to the margin and the leverage, we don't actually own the shares that we trade and that we hold, but we are borrowing them. And as you know, for every loan that you take, you have to pay an interest. In the most cases, the small retail traders are paying a very small long interest fees, so it doesn't matter too much, but nevertheless, you should know about this. On how it may affect your trading, most people will tell you that it's just another fee that you have to pay. However, if you look at the short interest for overnight borrowing, the situation there is quite different. Usually, the fees there are higher, but in some cases, when you're trading less liquid products, they can get so much higher that this could really affect your trade management and profit expectations. So, what is your actual risk? Usually, the risk with the overnight positions is related with the news and other factors which could affect your positions overnight, and in this way, when the security opens and if the movement is against your expectations, you are unprotected. When something like this happens, we call it a market gap, and these are the gaps that I told you into the previous lesson. In very rare occasions, the overnight risk is related with the short interest as well, because sometimes the short interest might get so much bigger that it can eat almost all of your profit. That's why you need an experienced coach who can guide you in the beginning, and with his guidance you can save such unexpected losses. The next slide is about position sizing. First are the lots. Usually into the forex sector, the position sizing is measured with lots. Depending from what currency pair you want to trade and what is its price, you will be able to trade certain amounts of lots, which will determine the size of your investment. Next are the units. The commodities and some other securities are usually traded in units. Basically, the lots and units are representing one and the same thing, the position size. However, due to the different sectors, they have slightly different specifications. When you're trading shares, the position size is determined from the numbers of shares that you're actually holding. Again, depending from the company share price, you'll be able to buy a certain amount of shares, which is going to be dependable from your capital. About what percent from your bank you should invest, we'll speak in more details in section 4 and the lessons about trade management. However, I already told you the golden rule, and it is never to invest more than you can actually afford to lose. But now I'm going to add something, and it is never to put your whole capital in only one position. It is always better to spread your investments into several different positions and, of course, into several different sectors. In this way, you're going to minimize the risk, and with proper trade management, you're going to maximize the profit. The online calculators are not my favorite tool because, in my opinion, calculations like this we should do alone for ourselves. Most of the platforms are doing all of these calculations for you anyway, so you just need to know how to use this in your favor. However, if you need help with the finding of one of these online calculators, you can leave a comment below this video and I'll text you with propositions what you can use. And in the end, we are reaching the position management. The first, and in my opinion, one of the most important things is the stop loss. No matter of what your plan is following and what is your trade management, you have to have maximum loss, after which you have to close your positions no matter what. The amount of this maximum loss should be determined mainly from your risk management strategy. And of course, after finishing this course, I'll show you a way how to put your stop loss combined with certain chart formations which will minimize the possibility for your stop loss to be hit from unexpected movements. The take profit is also very important because our main idea is to put it on a level where the price can actually reach. In this way, we are going to realize actual profit instead of having just a lot of positions waiting for the big move. The golden ratio here is 3-1. With other words, for every dollar that you might lose, you have to have the potential to win another 3. Basically, you have to aim your potential profit to be 3 times bigger than your potential loss. Now I'm going to show you one of my actual positions on the chart. This is one of my current trades. As you can see, it is the natural gas and the chart is on a daily time frame. And what is important here to see that this is my entry point. As you can see it, I mark it here. And I see the potential in this position that the price might reach up to here, which is actually, as you can see, 3 times bigger or even more than the level where I put my stop loss. Of course, there are people who are actively managing their positions and they have no electronic stop loss or take profit. However, I suggest you not to follow this approach because you have to stay constantly in front of your computer. Yes, sometimes if you are experienced traders, you might avoid some situations caused from panic selling, which with proper trade management will bring you profit in the end. But in my opinion, this is too risky for a beginner trader, and if trading is not something that you're doing all day long, I suggest you not to follow this approach. Use your electronic stops and take profit and follow your strategy. This is the end of lesson 3. I hope you like it and I hope it was useful for you. Of course, there will be more coming, and if you want to see more of our videos and other trades that we are posting, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the little bell. In this way, you're going to be notified immediately when we post something new in the channel. Thank you very much for your attention and see you again next time. Bye bye.